Good morning, Lancers. Welcome to this week's super edition of Lancers in the News. I'm Sarah George.
And I'm Marina Garcia.
Attention, Lancers. Today in homeroom, all 9th, 10th, and 11th grade students will receive their yearbook pictures. Makeup pictures are scheduled for Tuesday, September 29th. Please stop by the attendance office today or Monday or view the school website to receive a makeup order form. You must make an appointment at the attendance office Monday or Tuesday morning.
This past week was Almont's annual Youth Spirit Night for young students in the surrounding area. Lance reporter Rosemary Montes has the story.
Hi, my name is Matt and I'm going to become an Almont cheerleader today.
My name is Sophia and I'm going to be an Almont master cheerleader. I'm excited.
Hundreds of future Lancer cheerleaders, twirlers, and band members participated in the annual Youth Spirit Night last Friday. For many parents, this is an annual event.
This is, I believe, our third year participating in the Youth Cheer Camp, and we look forward to that. We have two of our alumni from St. John on the team, so we're here to support, of course, Bishop Almont and our girls.
Other parents learned about this event from Almont students.
I know about the youth camp through my daughter, Savannah Meave, who goes here. She's a junior, and she told us about this, and my little one wants to cheerlead, so we came to Almont.
Current Almont students enjoyed working with the young ones.
There was over 100 girls. I think that's the biggest we've had.
We're starting to really connect with the girls and stay more in contact with them so they can come back next year.
Yeah, like they come to our spring camp in the summer and then they come again during the fall season, so they must have fun since they keep coming back.
The day was highlighted with a halftime performance with Almont students and the kids. I'm Rosemary Montes reporting for the
Thanks, Rosemary. And now a reminder for all student drivers. Parking permits are now required for entrance to the student lot. Please display your permit in your rearview mirror and park your assigned spot, or your car may be towed without notification.
Pope Francis I is at this moment making his first trip to the United States. Lance reporter Iesha Magallanes asked several Lancers what questions they would have for the Pope.
On Wednesday morning, Pope Francis landed at Washington, D.C. He was greeted by both the President and the First Lady. We went around campus to figure out whether or not students had questions to ask the Pope surrounding the previous events of his papacy. So if you had the opportunity to sit down with the Pope, what would you talk to him about?
I'd ask him, does the Holy Grail exist?
I would ask if he can actually communicate with God and what it's like to live in Rome.
I could meet the Pope. I would probably confess my sins to him, all I've done.
I would ask when he got his calling and what was it like.
I want to ask the Pope, you should try In-N-Out because it's good.
How long do you spend on your Twitter?
I would ask him what's his favorite sport and who's his favorite team.
I'd ask him what kind of music he likes and if he listens to any rap music or anything.
So Pope Francis's biggest supporters and fans are apparently here to share some genuine facts about him.
He's very holy and he loves everyone.
Okay, so do you guys know any fun facts about the Pope?
There's only one Pope in the world.
He's holy.
I'm Aisha Magallanes, reporting from the Lance.
Thanks, Aisha. Lancers, the following colleges will be visiting our campus today. Today, LaSalle College and Chaminade University. Tuesday, Marymount California University and UC Santa Barbara. Wednesday, the Art Center College of Design. And Thursday, Concordia University, Portland and Northwestern Christian University. Please see Mr. Scott for a hall pass to any of these presentations.
Speaking of Mr. Scott, did you know that Almont has its very own college center on campus? Lance reporter Kendal Bernardez has some reasons why Lancers should visit Mr. Scott in the college center.
With college less than a year away, seniors are using the College Center with Mr. Scott to learn about prospective schools, fill out forms, and get overall advice. We asked seniors a few questions about the College Center and about Mr. Scott.
Do you think going to the College Center and going to Mr. Scott like prepares you for your future?
Yes, it does. I highly recommend it. He tells you everything you need to know for applying and how to get there.
I think Mr. Scott prepares me a lot for college. I'm a pretty stressed out person as it is, and whenever I go in there, he's always like reassuring me and telling me, like giving me all these college opportunities and things like that. So it definitely does help.
Have you been to the College Center with Mr. Scott?
Yes, I have been to the College Center multiple times for
working on scholarships or even like when a college visits. For example, yesterday I was there with the USC, and I plan to go in the future as well.
You go visit the College Center. It's wonderful, and they have a bunch of college flags, and I recommend it. You should do it.
Mr. Scott also has advice for any seniors who may be stressing out about the upcoming year.
The first thing that they should try to do is register for any remaining SAT or ACT exams that they need to take. And they should also now begin to start work on their CSU application, the UC application, and the Common Application for private schools. Another thing that they should also be doing right now is they should be completing a draft of their UC personal statement if they're applying to the UC campuses, and they should also be completing a draft of the essay for the Common Application.
Mr. Scott also advises seniors to listen to the morning announcements, check the website, and the counseling department is also available on Twitter for further help at Aumont Counseling. I'm Kendal Bernardez reporting for The Lance.
Thanks, Kendal. It's that time of the year again. The homecoming dance, Aumont Takes Miami, will be held on October 17th. Here's ASB with a special announcement.
Hello, my fellow Lancers. Julian Jacone and Michael Vaca here. Today is the last day to purchase pre-sale tickets for our homecoming dance, Aumont Takes Miami. Pre-sale tickets are sold $35 per person. Regular tickets start on Monday for $40. Check out the ASB table in the front office at lunch to get your tickets.
We will have a contest for those asking the dates on homecoming. Whoever asks in the most creative way will win free homecoming tickets. Post a picture on Instagram and tag at AumontASB, and ASB will vote for the winner. And ladies, remember to get your dress approved.
Just a reminder, any female students planning to attend homecoming must have their dresses pre-approved. Please bring your dress to campus with a photocopy of your dress and a student-parent agreement form. Dress approval will take place in the 300 Wing Dean's Office during lunch and after school from Monday, September 28th, to Thursday, October 15th. Please don't delay.
Do you need service hours? If so, please see Mr. Castellag in the Christian Service Office for a variety of opportunities. Also, Sacred Heart West Covina's Parish Festival will be held from October 2nd to 4th. If you'd like to volunteer for service hours that weekend, please see Ms. Wendy Nugent in room 502.
Attention juniors and seniors applying for NHS. Please obtain a checklist from Mrs. Hatfield in room 504 before turning in your application. All NHS forms are due Thursday, October 1st. Thank you. And don't forget about tonight's Dog Pound Blackout. The football game against Notre Dame begins at 7 p.m. Come out and support our Lancers.
That's all for this week's announcements. Thank you for watching this edition of Lancers in the News.
Go Lancers!
So I really can't eat. Let's go. Don't wait.